This is the solution to written homework 012. So for part A, we've got the whole real line. According to the definition of open from the previous exercise, we can just select any x. Let x be in the reals in no particular spot. Set epsilon as 1 or any positive number that you like. Then x minus epsilon to x plus epsilon is a subset of the reals. Therefore, the reals are open. Okay, so part B. From the previous exercise, we know that the empty set is open. Therefore, the reals, which are the complement of the empty set, is closed. Because that's what it means to be closed. Okay, for part C. We want to show that that is open. So notice that the complement of that set is the set negative infinity to zero, negative infinity to zero, and then union one to infinity. Which is just to say that here's 0 to 1, both endpoints included, and then the complement of that is, of course, 0 to 1, like this. So that's the complement. And from the previous exercise, we showed pieces like this are open. Therefore, the union is open because we could just process them one at a time. Therefore, negative infinity to zero, union one to infinity is open. And therefore, 0 to 1, which is the complement of all of that, so negative infinity to 0, union 1 to infinity, complement is closed. So that's C, and then D. Well, this one is easy. Negative infinity to 0 is 0 to infinity complement, and that's open, and therefore the complement is closed. And that's it.